Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll show you how to customize the default behavior of dialog editing in our data grid control for Blazor. The data grid is a templated Blazor component, meaning you can customize different parts of the UI using the template parameter. You can also use your own logic based on the custom components or content. In some cases, you might need to add new field editors to the edit dialog that are not present in the column model. The template dialog will help you customize the default edit dialog in such cases. To do this, I'll open the existing project and where I have included the SF grid code with properties like data source to bind order data and added grid columns tag to display and customize specific columns with properties like fields, header text, text align, and width. I enable dialog editing in the data grid by setting the mode property of the grid edit settings component to dialog. Look at the output now. The data grid is rendered with the orders data with the fields order ID, customer name, and ship country. Now, while editing this record, a dialog will be opened with the same fields. Notice here, the columns order date and ship address are not bound to the grid columns but are available in the data source. Now in this dialog, I'm going to display 5 columns, order ID, customer name, order date, ship country, and ship address. I will render my own editors using the dialog template by wrapping the HTML elements or Syncfusion components inside the template property of the grid edit settings tag. Within this template, I'll define a local variable called order and create a new instance of the context class for the object. Next, I will add a div element as a wrapper for the dialog content. Then I'll define the div element for a row and column alignment with appropriate CSS classes. First, I'll use the numeric editor for the order ID column. To use the numeric text box, I must add the namespace Syncfusion Blazor inputs. Then I add the SF numeric text box tag. I need to perform two-way binding with the numeric text box component by using the @bind value property for the order ID field. Also, I will add the enabled property so that I can enable or disable this field based on the add request using the onActionBegin event. So I will add the grid events tag with the property tValue to specify the model type as orderDetails. Then I will add the onActionBegin event and assign the onActionBeginHandler callback method. I declare a boolean variable called isAddNew to check whether the add request has been received and store the result inside this callback method and assign it to the enabled property. I add the placeholder property and set its value to orderID. Also, I add the float label type property to align the label and set its value to always. I mention the value type for this component by setting tValue property to integer. Now I'll use the AutoComplete component for the customer ID column. To use the AutoComplete component, add the namespace Syncfusion Blazor dropdowns. I add the div element for column with appropriate CSS classes. Then I add the SF AutoComplete tag. Next, I'll include the data source property and set its value as orders. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the fields property of the AutoComplete component. Therefore, I need to define the AutoComplete field settings tag and map the field customer ID to the value property. Also, I need to specify the data source type, so let me define a property tItem and set its value as orderDetails. I need to specify the AutoComplete value field type, so I'll set tValue as a string. I need to define the @bindValue property with the value customer ID to support two-way binding across the Blazor data grid and AutoComplete components. Finally, I set the placeholder and float label type properties with appropriate values. Next, I'll use the DatePicker for the order date column. To use the DatePicker component, add the namespace Syncfusion Blazor calendars. Then I add the div element for row and column alignment with appropriate CSS classes. And then I add the SF DatePicker tag. Also, I need to perform two-way binding with a DatePicker component using the @bindValue property for the orderDate field. I set the placeholder and float label type properties with appropriate values. Now I'll use the dropdown list for the ship country column. To use the dropdown list component, we need the Syncfusion Blazor dropdown's namespace, which I have already added. Then I add the div element for order date column with appropriate CSS classes to align it, and add the SF dropdown list tag. I'll include the data source property and set its value as orders. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the fields property of the dropdown list component. Therefore, I need to define the dropdown list field settings tag and map the field ship country to the value property. I add the text property to map the ship country column from the orders data table for each list item. Also, I need to specify the data source type, so let me define a property tItem and set its value as order details. Then I also need to specify the dropdown list value field type, so I'll set a T value as a string. Also, I need to define the addBind value property with the value ship country to support two-way binding across the Blazor data grid and dropdown list components. I set the placeholder and float label type properties with appropriate values. Finally, I'll use the text box for the ship address column. To use the text box component, we need the Syncfusion Blazor inputs namespace, which I added previously. Then I add the div element for row alignment with appropriate CSS class to align it, and add the SF text box tag. Also, I need to perform two-way binding with the text box component using the addBind value property for the ship address field. I set the placeholder and float label type properties with appropriate values. Now I'll run the sample and show you the dialog. Look at the output page. When I click Add button in the toolbar, the dialog will be opened. Here you can edit the fields using the Numeric TextBox component for the order ID column, the AutoComplete component for the customer name column, the DatePicker component for the order date column, the dropdown list component for the ship country column, and the text box component for the ship address column. Once the details are updated, I can save the changes using the Save button in the dialog. When I double click on the existing record, notice here the order ID field is in disabled state, and I'll modify other fields and save the changes. Let me recap what we have seen so far. I have customized the data grid editing dialog using Numeric TextBox, AutoComplete, DatePicker, dropdown list, and text box components. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video. You can also look into getting a free license key to use our Blazor products if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. See you next time.